How you doing? This is Ivan with Bitesize Wisdom for Busy People, and I'm back with another idea to help you live more consciously. Today, our topic is on time is thought. We live in a world that is dominated by thought. Thought has allowed us to create a materially comfortable world. It's allowed some amazing inventions to come to life, but at the same time, it has enslaved us, as evidenced by the levels of unhappiness and depression that people deal with. Despite that the common man has more wealth than even kings had not long ago, on the quest towards inner freedom, it is essential that we come to an intimate understanding of thought, of what thought is, that we question it. It's very difficult for many of us because thought is so close and invisible to us that we just take it for granted. We just know we have it, and we get so wrapped up in it that we end up deriving a majority of our sense of self, of our identity from it. And thought is essentially just a response from our memory cells. Memory is just a record of the past, of our experiences. Thought can also project itself forward by speculating about the future. We then live in a world of conceptual stories whose objective is just to continue in time. If we are clear what thought is, and our relationship to it, we can use it skillfully for its utility value. But when we look to thought to tell us what we really are, to give us the answers, to fill the void of meaning that we are searching for, it is impossible for it. It can only point and indicate the way. Thought equals time, and to be identified to thought is to be stuck in psychological time. To live in real time, you need to be established in that from which thought arises, that which is outside of time. Many people get a taste of this indirectly in any activity that slows thought down. Although they attribute their sense of well-being to the activity, it's the appeal of many sports, of traveling. Also, when having an orgasm, many get a small glimpse. Next time, try to see if you're thinking in that short interval. When you think of a memory from the past, that which was present then as the silent background of awareness is also present now. When you think of tomorrow, it is arising from this timeless beingness and will be perceived by the same timeless beingness. When chronologically it arrives as today, beingness contains all potentialities. If you can be established in your beingness, then you will zoom out from the horizontal time to then be able to see it unfold moment to moment. This is going with the flow of life. If you are too identified to your mind, to your body, you are too zoomed in into the material dimension and lose sight of the vertical dimension of consciousness, of your timeless beingness. Our bodies help us to be able to perceive this intersection of the horizontal and the vertical dimensions, which may be the real symbolic meaning of the cross. This is the miracle of our existence. You can equate truth to that which never changes and that which changes as the false. This is why no matter what you accomplish or acquire in time, it never ultimately fulfills you. Only the timeless, the formless, only the truth shall set you free. And then when the two becomes one, you shine like the sun. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's topic. If you did, please hit the subscribe button and the little notification bell. That way you know when I upload new content. And tell a friend, help out my little YouTube channel. I really appreciate it. Wherever you are in the world, I hope you're doing well. Take care. Peace.